I caught part of the question, so forgive me if you have to repeat part of the other. But I heard the beginning in terms of Ben and Javier, who regrettably are not able to be here today. They wish they could. Javier is working on Ridley Scott's film and is tied up in London. Ben is, of course, preparing for Argo's release. And both of them regret they're not here and look forward to speaking about the film in the coming weeks. And then the second part of the question I did not get. That was a decision, and we apologize if you were offended by it, honestly. But we like for Terry's films to be able to speak for themselves and for all of us to go to them with an open heart and not preconceived notions. So we felt that it was in the best interest of the film to provide for the most fresh viewing today.
No, I don't really see a contradiction in that at all. I believe that love is the most mysterious emotion of all. And I think love does continue, and no matter what happens in your life, as things change, you maybe can't live. This to me is a story about two people who are deeply passionate about each other, but can't live with each other. But that doesn't mean they don't love each other. And I believe everyone may take, they understand a little differently, but I understand it to say, in this particular case, they're better apart, and their love strengthens because of it.
I don't see the problem at all. I think it's absolutely normal that the person who, if they're willing to, if they're separating with the person they love, they want to keep the name. Why not? Separation doesn't mean the end of love. People separate for multiple reasons. People separate for tons of completely different reasons. And I'm sure it happened to many of people that sit here. It's not, love sometimes is eternal. And probably, at least I know for my character, this love is eternal. I know she will love him until the rest of her days, and that's what keeps her alive. And she does say it. There's in the voiceover, there are things that will love you forever, and you give me the strength to go forward. And your love carries me. So I don't see that.
But there is a transition of your character from Europe to America and then back to Europe twice. Can you describe a little bit how you envision it?
It's basically the relationship in the movie is the relationship of a couple that just can't go through it. They just can't live together. Very often it happens that people love each other, but that in an everyday life they're incapable of coexisting, and this is exactly that particular case that is shown. That's why they separate many times, they go back and forth, they think it's over, and very often it happens that you separate with someone, but you realize you do love the person, you go back, and then people, you know, many times they separate and they go back and they try again because they still believe, because actually what really carries us is love. It's really not the everyday quotidian life and problems. Those we have tendency to begin to forget very quickly because love really sometimes conquers all, or so we believe. And I think that's why people always have hope. They have hope. This time it will work. This time it will work. And it just doesn't and doesn't and doesn't. And sometimes it does work, but for our couple, for the couple in the movie, it doesn't until the end. And it is very, there is a question that arises, is there free will? Or is there something that's decided above us? There's something bigger. And no matter what we are gonna have a certain, we do have our destiny, no matter what we do.
Sì, ecco. La cosa bella di lavorare con Terrence Malick è anche appunto questa generosa libertà o apparente libertà che ci viene data, perché a volte è tale. E è un regista molto attento, a volte viene descritto come maniacale. Io dico che è sicuramente un uomo molto profondo, che scava nell'anima, un uomo e un regista curioso, molto, molto leggero anche quando va in profondità. E sì, sicuramente i suoi film sono dei film fatti di immagini meravigliose, e appunto sia il corpo che la parola hanno un'importanza che si equivalente. Sono un po' in imbarazzo nel dover parlare del film, perché credo che questa sera sarò la spettatrice più curiosa di questo film, non avendo visto nulla. E per questo motivo faccio difficoltà, quindi posso raccontare la mia esperienza con Terrence Malick, ma non quello che riguarda il film, appunto, non avendo visto.
I was delighted to meet Terrence, of course, because I was a big fan of his movies beforehand, and during the audition he was present, and he, it's funny because he actually came in the room very quietly. I almost didn't notice him, and he tried to work with me, but he mostly just watched. He gave me a lot of freedom, and from that moment I felt, honestly, I did feel the connection. I knew he didn't have to tell me he was going to work with me. I think I had a feeling. The way he spoke to me, we had a long conversation afterwards, and the way he spoke to me, I could see he basically, indirectly told me that I was a character. So I really felt that we got along, and the telepathy between us was amazing, because on set he didn't really need to speak to me that much. I just knew what he wanted me to do. I don't know how, but I understand him so well. I just know exactly what he wants. It's an amazing communication. He feels people. He sees you through. He knew exactly who I am from the moment he met me, without even speaking to me. I think he's psychic. It's a bit scary, but he's a very thorough person. He takes care about the character, the actor he works with. And I think with every actor, he spoke differently, because he finds a way of talking to every person on a different level. And that's where he's very, very smart. That's how he gets amazing